Senate Republicans turned their back on Donald Trump. Find out why today on Tracing the Facts.
Hey, yo, I love when cats think they're bigger than a sumo. That's when I hit them with a little Puerto Rican judo. Oh, you don't know what that is. That's when I say, you don't know who got this thing.
And you don't know?
What's going on, everybody, and welcome to my show, Tracing the Facts. I'm your host, a nonpartisan Puerto Rican, and today I wanted to discuss a bill that was passed yesterday by the United States Senate with an overwhelming 86 to 14. What that basically means is that 86 votes to 14 grants the U.S. Senate a supermajority. What that means is that the bill that was passed on the Senate level is veto proof. It cannot be vetoed or overturned by Donald Trump. Now, the reason this is important to note is because, as you guys remember, it wasn't but less than a week ago that Donald Trump threatened the Defense Department with vetoing a defense bill if they were to go ahead with plans, which was to rename many government and military facilities that are associated in name or entitled with the Confederates. Because of this, instead of Republicans on the Senate level siding with Donald Trump, what ended up happening was that they ended up siding with the Democrats in order to grant them a supermajority, one that the president could not veto. And through this bill, which was passed yesterday, known as the Defense Appropriations Bill, they would then enforce the provisions to rename the facilities that are named after Confederate soldiers or Confederate titles, etc., etc. Now, as it states right here, it says the Senate passed an annual defense policy bill on Thursday, which was yesterday, with strong support from both parties. 86 to 14 basically means that, as we all know, it was expected for Democrats to all vote in favor of this, and it was expected for Republicans to actually side with Donald Trump. But that's not what ended up happening. 86 to 14 means that you have around 47 Democrats in Senate, and you have around 51 or 52 Republicans. So when you look at it, it basically means that around 37 or 38 Republicans sided with the Democrats and granted them legal authority to enforce this bill, because now they have something known as the supermajority. The supermajority is the only way to create a veto-proof bill, which basically means that not even the president of the United States can overturn the decision, because it is represented by more than 3/4 of those representing that chamber in Congress. So the Senate version of the national defense is gonna authorize $740 billion, which I believe was originally passed on the original part of the budget. There was $1.2 trillion that was passed, I believe, on November or December of 2019. But I guess I was wrong, or either that or we're spending money at this rate. But an additional $740 billion for national security programs, which includes, of course, border security. 3% hike in pay raise for troops, and $44 million for corona vaccines, even though America has already purchased more than 100 million vaccines from Pfizer, I believe, is the one that is manufacturing the remdesivir version, American version of the hydroxychloroquine, etc. Medicine that you all brought everything together, so it's kind of hard to keep track with what it is that specifically is part of the ingredients of this new supposed vaccine, or how it's supposed to work. Now, conclusively, this is what I'm asking myself. If this kind of divisiveness where Republicans continues on towards November election, this could definitely lead to culturally fractionalizing Republicans, and through that, fractionalizing the power of their vote. Because if there are going to be people that are going to align with traditional Republicans, such as what happened on the U.S. Senate, where 36 to 38 members of the Republican Party abandoned the supposed loyalty that they hold for their party's agenda and sided with the Democrats. If this were to happen a few more times, it could lead to cultural polarization amongst Republicans and conservatives, and ultimately can affect the numbers come 2020's election. Think about the fact that even though when Donald Trump was on the trails in 2016, he, because of him and because of his popularity, Donald Trump led to the win of all three houses, the House of Representatives, the U.S. Senate, and the presidency. But by 2018, when the midterm elections came around, Republicans ended up losing the House of Representatives because on a district-by-district level, the Republicans weren't too popular, even if Donald Trump was. So what will we witness this time around? Will we witness the same movement, the silent majority, that propelled Donald Trump onto his presidency? Or will we see a smaller wave of populists supporting Donald Trump and failing once again to support their party or their agenda through the parties that align with their agenda? Because ultimately and conclusively, most people these days claim to be independents, but most of them either lean towards the left or lean towards the right. This all matters because conclusively it leads people to either support what the narrative and what the agenda is, and what the narrative and what the agenda might not be. So this is just some thoughts for you guys. I believe that this will affect 2020 for the House and the Senate. And this is a bad thing for Republicans because of the simple reason that they already lost the House of Representatives in 2018. If they lose the Senate, then they'll lose both chambers in the House of Representatives. And these are the chambers that are in charge of both proposing and passing bills. And if they can attain a supermajority, around 75 in the Senate, then the same thing that just happened yesterday will once again happen. Not even Donald Trump would be able to stop the agenda of the Democrats were this to happen. I want you guys to share your thoughts. Enjoy the rest of your days. God bless, stay safe, and stay informed.
Yo, I love when cats think they're bigger than a sumo. That's when I hit them with a little Puerto Rican judo. Oh, you don't know what that is. That's when I say, you don't know who got this thing.
And you don't know?